is Michelle. Parliament has passed the 30 trillion shillings budget framework paper for the 2017-18 financial year. The budget framework paper was discussed by the budget committee chaired by Ntenjeru North MP Amos Lugurobi with some recommendations. Key among the recommendations is that government should only acquire loans after preparing adequately for the intended project to enable adequate absorption capacity. While passing the budget framework paper, the Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, asked government to implement the recommendations made by the budget committee.
Hello, members. The question is that the budget framework paper be approved with the amendments proposed by the chairperson and the conditions attached by the same. Those in favor say the contrary, no.
Earlier on, Moses Waliyeku, the Jinja Municipality West MP, told Parliament called for allocation of adequate resource for promoting industrialization in the country to help local investors.
They have allocated 50 billion. We are talking about industrialization. We are talking about helping local investors also borrowing from that bank. 50 billion is $15 million. 5 borrowers are going to finish the money. Even one. So what kind of capitalization are we doing in this bank? So I want to call upon government. Let us be serious on this issue of the development bank. $15 million is a drop in an ocean. We cannot afford to have a development bank which has a capital of $15 million in this era.
David Bahati, the State Minister for Planning, said government is taking steps in ministries and departments intended to address the problem of increasing domestic arrears.
Because a big part of the domestic arrears is in government utilities, payment of utilities. So we want every government institution to be on prepaid.
The Public Accounts Committee of Parliament has put to task a team from the Works Ministry to explain anomalies in procurement of contracts under this sector. The anomalies were first raised in the June 2015 Auditor General's report. The report questioned the lack of contract implementation plans on 11 procurements. According to the Auditor General, lack of implementation plans for contracts could lead to poor contract management and failure to obtain value for money. Bageya Waiswa, the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Works, was unable to provide an explanation to questions on mismanagement within the procurement and disposal unit of the ministry, while attempts by the Commissioner for Public Structures, Edward Simbwa, to explain the query were also rejected.
Read your submission, your response is on page 8 at the bottom.
Yes.
That's in case you have forgotten.
Yes, I'm just affirming what is there, that this information was not there at the time, was misplaced. But
you read verbatim, read that statement down there.
At the time of audit, the above procurement files lacked contract management plans. However, subsequent procurements, the issue of contract management plans has been adhered to.
Yes, and you are very clear here that the contract plans were not available at the time.
Lumiaga County MP Theodore Sechikubo accused him of failing to effectively manage his team.
Mr. Waiswa, the accounting officer, are you in charge of the ministry? Or someone just came in from Barara and the procurement heads were elsewhere? Did you have a midnight meeting before you came here? Of course, all these things would have been having answers. We have said this one, the answer is ABCD. Maybe where you are not sufficient, you say a member can chip in. But once you ask that we discharge you, we are still holding you because these queries need to be answered.
PAC also accused works officials of deliberately spending 157 million shillings to fund activities that were not planned for without Parliament approval. The Assistant Commissioner for Accounts, Lubama Jimmy, did not have information relating to which items had been affected as a result of the mischarge.
We are asking for related items, stationary costs. Where you move the money, stationary, because consultants require stationary workshops.
Are you just assuming how much came from workshops? How much came from stationary? How did you arrive at that?
Madam Chair, I cannot.
No, because you are beginning to create some imagination.
Yes, Madam Chair.
If you know that it's stationary workshops, you should know how much came from which one.
The Public Service Commission, PSC, under the Ministry of Public Service, has ordered the Rukunjiri District Service Commission to rescind promotions of 4 district officers to higher posts. Dr. John Geoffrey Mbabazi, the Secretary of Public Service Commission, directed the Rukunjiri Kao Milton Cattle to redesignate the 4 officers back to their previous positions due to their lack of academic qualifications for these promotions. The DSC had promoted Fatima Kamanzi from District Information Officer to Senior Assistant Secretary, Kaumuza Nicholas Kohli, from Community Development Officer to Senior Assistant Secretary, Sylvia Kemitsha, formerly Community Development Officer to Senior Assistant Secretary, and Evers Kutunji, from Development Officer to Senior Assistant Secretary. Dr. Mbabazi, however, ordered that new appointments of Mutunji Katirimba as Senior Human Resource Officer and Dan Tuliamreva as Human Resource Officer from Community Development Officer be upheld. The PSC boss also ordered disciplinary action against the DSC Secretary Stanley Munavi for failing to guide the District Commission not to promote unqualified persons. The orders follow a petition by Rukunjiri LC5 Chairman Andrew on Katebire to the PSC on the questionable promotions. The Luengo Resident District Commissioner, RDC Harriet Nakamia, has instructed police to carry out impromptu inspections of bars to arrest proprietors who open beyond 10 p.m. According to Ms. Nakamia, who also chairs the District Security Committee, the night curfew will enable security agencies hunt down those currently terrorizing people in the district. The RDC was addressing residents of Chiseka Trading Center in Chiseka Sub-County at the commissioning of Chiseka Police Post this week. Flanked by the Southern Regional Police Commander, Mr. Latif Zake, and Bokoto South MP Haj Muhammad Muyanjan Papali, Ms. Nakamia said without restricting the time of operation for birds and sports betting joints, more insecurity reports would be registered in the district. And also, U.S. Defense Secretary James Mattis is in South Korea for the first foreign trip by the senior official in the Trump administration. Mr. Mattis is expected to use the visit to reassure Seoul of continuing U.S. commitment to security deals in the face of threats from North Korea. While campaigning, Donald Trump accused South Korea and Japan of not paying enough for the U.S. military support, that he also suggested they could be allowed to arm themselves with nuclear weapons. Both Japan and South Korea rejected this deal.
Health Tip is sponsored by Flucamol, your medication of choice for curing colds immediately.
Before buying anything, read food labels. Pick healthy foods that provide nutrients like vitamins, minerals, and dietary fiber, but limit sodium, added sugar, saturated fat, and trans fat. A very good morning. That's all we could get for you.